thought that I had fell off. Then I sat back like you crazy, why you know you well off. Everything I had was running. Inside, on the side, I was dead. No chance you could see who was in it. At the mall, I was pitching my penis. In the beginning, Jimmy Jazz for the clothes, TV Johnny for the gold. That was the goal. Then I kept it on my soul. I can wait till I get old. Mommy's hold up. Wait a minute, new beginning. I was down now, honey. I know who did it and I don't forget it. You know I'm still about the family business. Gotta get back.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. North Greenville University and Noah Greer would like to welcome you to Pepsi Stadium here on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. Tonight's matchup features the Lakers of Clayton State taking on your North Greenville Crusaders. And now, let's meet the starting lineups first for the visiting Lakers. In goal, number 25, Larry Greer. At defender, number 4, Tim Newcesser. At defender, number 5, Jordan Knight. At midfield, number 6, Dusan Stankovic. At forward, number 9, Dean Foster. At midfield, number 10, Mitro Turunen. At forward, number 12, Brad Kay. At defender, number 14, Hector Gutierrez. At defender, number 17, Kwaku Guamina. At defender, number 19, Baylor Asher. And in midfield, number 21, Jack Stevens. The head coach of the Lakers is Mr. Pete Peterson. He's assisted by Avery Shepard and Trent Orndorff. And now for your North Greenville Crusaders. In goal, a sophomore from Cleveland, Georgia, number 88, Noah Kindred. At defender, a sophomore from Greenville, South Carolina, number 7, Dylan Erkin. At forward, a sophomore from Taylor, South Carolina, number 9, Garrett Green. Midfield, a junior from Manizales, Colombia, number 10, Kike Molina. At midfield, a senior from Flint, Michigan, number 11, Casey Brady. At defense, a sophomore from Seneca, South Carolina, number 12, Gus Johnson. At midfield, a junior from Cypress, Texas, number 18, James Segovia. At midfield, a senior from Gastonia, North Carolina, number 19, Jake Quinn. At forward, a junior from Greer, South Carolina, number 20, Nick Roberson. At forward, a freshman from Taylor, South Carolina, number 28, Zach Baker. And a defender, a freshman from Newburgh, Indiana, number 37, Rolando Macias. The head coach of your North Greenville Crusaders is Mr. Bill Martin. He's assisted by Brett Baker, Samuel Greeley, and graduate assistant Ron Legaldo. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise. And gentlemen, remove your caps for the invocation given tonight by Ops Specialist Ben Thompson, and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for the safe travel of the visiting team. I pray now that you would keep both teams safe as they compete and help them to glorify you, win or lose. In your name I pray. Amen.
Another exciting edition of Crusaders Soccer.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. You are looking at Pepsi Stadium here on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes a difference. Today, we've got the Clayton State Lakers out of Morrow, Georgia, coming to Tigerville for the first time in 12 years as they get ready to take on the homestanding North Greenville University Crusaders. Grace Sutherland with you tonight. Be joined by Alan Ellis in just a moment. But we have some orders of business to take care of before the teams get on the field. And just mentioned, first time in 12 years these teams have faced off here in Tigerville. And Clayton State versus North Greenville. They're out of the Peach Belt Conference, a conference that North Greenville is familiar with, playing baseball and several softball series with. Clayton State 4-0 against North Greenville as a career record, Alan.
Absolutely. And then on, but you look at that, it's been a while. It's been 12 years since I've been to Tigerville, 11 years since these teams have come against each other. North Greenville 2-1-1 to start the season. Clayton State 1-3-1 to start there. So you look at the records, North Greenville might have an upper hand here to start off.
And they're going to have to score goals quick and often as opportunities present themselves. Clayton State and those four matchups previous have outscored North Greenville 23-3. North Greenville didn't even score in the first two times these teams matched up. So we'll get you the starting 11 for both teams. In goal for Clayton State, it'll be number 25, Larry Frere, a goalkeeper. At defense, Tim Nuesser. Number 5, Jordan Knight at defense. Dusan Stankovic at midfield. Also at midfield, Metro Tarunen. Number 12, Brad Kay at forward. At defender, number 12, you've got Hector Gutierrez. Number 17, Kwaku Dwamina. And he is at defender as the opening kick is away. And we'll continue with the lineups. Number 19, Baylor Asher at defense. Jack Stevens at midfield. Siobhan Blake at forward. And Dean Foster also out there, but not with a listed position. That's starting lineup for Clayton State, who is already pressing into the North Greenville box, trying to get a chip shot up and out of bounds off the foot of, there was Siobhan Blake. It'll be a goal kick for Noah Kendrick. It's back in goal for North Greenville.
And that's the kind of intensity Clayton State's going to bring today. They've had a history of beating North Greenville. We've gone over that, and it's been not even close, really. A 21-goal lead, and they don't want that to really dwindle at all.
Starting 11 for North Greenville, mentioned Kendrick back in goal. At for defenders, you've got Dylan Erkins, Gus Johnson, Jake Quinn, and Rolando Macias. At midfielders, you've got Kike Molina, Casey Brady, James Segovia. And your forwards, Gareth Green, Nick Roberson, and Zach Baker. And North Greenville trying to press at the other end. Clayton State defending the left end goal. North Greenville defending the right end goal. Now the field completely shaded as the sun's setting off to the west, just off to our left.
And Gray, not a bad attack from North Greenville to start off, showing that they're not really going to back down to this Clayton State attack as much as they might have thought.
And something we've seen here in the first 2 minutes is Clayton State has speed, and they're going to use that early and often. They're just presented from that attack by, I believe that was number 10, Metro Tarunen, trying to press the right wing. But North Greenville did do a very solid job of counterattacking from Nick Roberson. Player you're going to have to watch there on the right wing, Siobhan Blake. Clayton State going to him once again, and North Greenville is going to kick it out of bounds. A couple players to keep your eye on for North Greenville, number 11, Casey Brady, and number 18, James Segovia, are a couple of Crusaders to watch today. North Greenville still trying to get out of their defensive part of the field.
And right there, taking that ball away is the third Crusader that really needs to be recognized. Number 9, Gareth Green, been a leader for this North Greenville team in only, what, his second season. Been fairly good on the attack and scored several goals last season. Would look to keep that trend going here.
Trying to get a pass down the field, looking for Roberson again, but it was headed away by Clayton State. North Greenville able to get it back, though. And North Greenville's going to have to be possession heavy today. They can't give up easy passes to Clayton State as we have our first whistle and a foul. And it will be against the Lakers of Clayton State, so free kick coming up for NGU.
Dylan Erkins, falling off the foot of a Laker, and that's going to open up an opportunity here for North Greenville.
Trying to get into the box. Gareth Green is there, though. He lines it up, and they shoot. Scores!
And that was just perfect right there. They had to go back. The goalie has to come off the crease, has to protect from Gareth Green. But that opens up the man streaking down from the midfield. Wide open goal, and now it's 1-0 North Greenville.
And you saw it. I only saw it in a flash. It was number 28, Zach Baker, who came flying in to get the ricochet from Gareth Green. And the freshman from Taylor, South Carolina, the general out of Wade Hampton High School, Zach Baker, puts North Greenville up 1-0. And how important is it early that North Greenville gets a goal here within the first 5 minutes? How important was that?
That's very important that North Greenville scores a goal. You know, get that monkey off your back. You've only scored, what, two goals all time against this team. Go ahead, get one early. And now you're forcing Clayton State to play on the back foot for over 85 minutes if this continues at this pace.
Second goal.
Yeah, you second one.
A second goal on the season for Zach Baker. And now you can begin that quest for the second goal.
And this is just the thing that happens. Now Clayton State going to have to play a lot more defensively to try not to give up another goal, but an opportunity coming here on the outside of the box.
And they've got four defenders drifting back to help guard. North Greenville has the ball. Here comes across into the box and stopped in its tracks by Frere. Up front, Clayton State with Tarunen. And now they will go to Blake. Or no, that's number 17. That's number 17, Kwaku Dwamina. Nice defensive play by North Greenville there in the midfield. It was, it looks like a number 11 with Casey Brady coming up to make the defensive play, the midfielder. Senior for head coach Bill Martin out of Flint, Michigan. Greenville's going to have to play smart defensively. Saw a little bit of a jersey tug there from Segovia trying to keep up with number 12, Brad Kay. Clayton State, right now, if this was a 100-meter sprint, I feel Clayton State would beat North Greenville every time.
But luckily for North Greenville, that's only an aspect of the game and not the entirety of it. Playing really good off the back line, letting the midfielders do most of the work. North Greenville just essentially sending four to stand in front of the box and daring Clayton State to beat all of them.
Yeah, Segovia is going to be tough to beat today for North Greenville, as possession will point to Clayton State. And on that defensive back line, North Greenville, Gus Johnson, he's back there, at a junior out of Seneca, South Carolina. Number 19, Jake Quinn. So those defenders for North Greenville, they're going to be called upon today as they're going to be feeling a lot of heat.
But through the first couple minutes, just doing a really good job of standing in passing lanes, and look at the opportunity that's opening up. It's going to be called offside. Nick Robertson just a step ahead, but the opportunity was there.
I like the idea. Segovia trying to get forward to Roberson. I like the idea. Take what the defense is giving to you, press up field, and just try and find the gaps, because North Greenville, it appears to me that over the past couple of seasons has had trouble with passing. They have given away too many wayward passes, and head coach Martin adjusting to that, trying to play to his team's strength, and he's got them up 1-0 right now.
And you're going to look back at this, and you're going to see a lot of this attack is going to start in the midfield for North Greenville, with those four defenders standing as kind of an extra insurance policy on any attack. Most of every offensive play is going to start in the midfield off a pass.
North Greenville working the left edge of the box. Now it's cut away by Stankovic. And now they've got help running down midfield. Dwamina getting to the box and almost an open goal as the goalie and Dwamina collide. But it looks like it will be a offensive foul, if you will, against Clayton State.
Yeah, a little bit of a tug of the jersey to pull down the defender. And that's going to work in the favor of North Greenville. not exactly what you'd expect if you're on the Clayton State side, what you'd hope, but one of those bang-bang plays and no penalty kick going to be awarded here.
And we'll wait for the goal kick from Kendrick. Number 17, Kwaku Dwamina, another good player to watch for Clayton State today. Leads are tied for the lead on the team with goals. Him and Brad Kay each have two. Dwamina does have three assists and seven total points. So number 17 locking down the mid part of the field there for Clayton State. Definitely a guy to watch as now they've got Siobhan Blake running down the right side, but the pass too far in front of him. And North Greenville gets away with the one there, goal kick for Kendrick.
And North Greenville, really, they can't afford to keep letting up these big plays up the sideline. Yes, great defensively so far through these first 10 minutes, but that's going to wear down from time to time. And it's really what's going to wear out first through everything, this quick attack out of Clayton State or this hard-nosed defense North Greenville's playing.
Another goal kick coming up for Kendrick. Just joining us, North Greenville leading 1-0. A goal 4 minutes in, scored by Zach Baker, has put the Crusaders up over the Lakers. And not much noise out of Clayton State since then. Trying to make some here with Dwamina, going to him early and often, and North Greenville, good defensive play, as it was number 19. Jay Quinn back there ripping it away from the best Laker out there. Now, some may argue that there could be some argument to that point, especially if you're in Los Angeles.
Yeah, I'm sure number 24 is a little more well-known.
Well, number 24, what else did he wear? Number, was it eight or nine? Also, totally different sport.
Yeah, that's besides the point. Same mascot.
Well, yeah. Clayton State also wearing kind of like Clemson orange out there. And North Greenville going with another home alternate uniform. We got the white, solid white back, but on the front it's the gradient white to black to match the shorts.
I'm a fan of these jerseys. They match the red ones, just a different color set.
As long as I can see the numbers, they can wear whatever they want. Just make the numbers bright and prominent.
They are bright red and pretty easy to see.
Clayton State swapping it back and forth over the midfield stripe. North Greenville not letting anybody get around them now. Is there with Brad Kay getting tangled up with, I believe that was Gus Johnson.
And Butriago standing in the passing lane and forcing it back for a North Greenville counterattack.
And here's space on the right side for him. Looking for the open man, and what a block by Dwamina right into him.
That was more like an interception than anything else. He just caught that with his feet, brought it back down.
The footception?
Has that happened yet?
I don't know. I don't think DiCaprio's made that one yet. Another chip shot up, and Zach Baker running free in the box, but too far in front of him. And again, North Greenville putting pressure on that defensive back line for Clayton State as Roberson trying to find Baker.
North Greenville just trying to find an opportunity, getting there, forcing the defense off their back foot, and that's against a team that's historically dominated you in the goal scoring.
Yeah, that's outscored you by 21. Well, now I guess it's down to 20.
That's kind of what you need to see.
Yeah, coming into a game like this against a non-conference opponent, your conference schedule looming on the horizon, you just got to put that all out of your mind. You haven't played them here at home in 12 years. Now Clayton State with room. They've got Blake running right side, chip up into the box, and nobody home for the Lakers there.
Blake taking the opportunity, but just chipped a little too far. Had a couple men streaking towards the left side post, but well over their heads, and now North Greenville's going to retain possession.
Tarunen was a man who was in the middle of the box trying to get position on Kendrick out of Vantaa, Finland. this is quite a worldwide roster for Clayton State. You've got Finland, Italy, Spain, Germany, Serbia, Brazil, England, South Africa, Australia, and Jamaica. North Greenville room to the left side if they want it. They will take the opportunity. Macias over there looking into the corner. Picks up Roberson. Roberson looking for the cross. Still waiting on the cross. Low line drive comes. That's easily cleared out. And now that will trickle back to midfield. And here come the Lakers. And see some frustration there out of Tarunen. And kind of got left all by himself there on the right side. More good defensive play for North Greenville. Stolen away there by Erkins.
You know, the old saying, the best defense is a good offense, a lot of times doesn't really get flipped on its head as much as it should. North Greenville playing a lot of good defense so far, and that defense has led them to their opening goal and more than one opportunity.
Defense wins championships, right?
It does.
And here comes Gareth Green trying to get to it first. Can't do it. Has a defender one step ahead of him there for Clayton State. Not to worry, though. Roberson down the left wing. Looking for help in the box. He's got a couple. And he'll bounce it off a defender. And won't get lucky on that ricochet. And now there's a tackle on the turf. And a foul against Clayton State. And a good opportunity here on the free kick for North Greenville.
North Greenville already scored one off a nice set, so why not off a set piece?
See who lines up to come for it. Looks like Casey Brady. They're adjusting his socks. Looks like he's going to be the one to take it. He's also got Roberson back there with him, number 20. And they might try to feed it through to Kike Molina. Watch number 10 here on the cross, and he'll go right for the goal and score it on the free kick for Casey Brady, number 11.
Just a beautiful set right there playing off Nick Roberson. One fake, two fake, one kick, and it finds the left side. Now 2-0 North Greenville.
A very good start for North Greenville. Very good to see the Crusaders get off to this quick start. North Greenville's had an entire week off to prepare for this game off the conference tie against Lees McRae College. And that game was actually called tied at 2-2 with about a minute and a half left in the game. We were looking at overtime and that one. If a second band of thunderstorms hadn't popped up and both coaches agreed, we don't want to have to wait through another one. Let's just call it here and go home. North Greenville does have a conference win in their pockets off a win over Erskine. Now it's back underway here, just under 29 minutes to play until half. North Greenville leads 2-0. Casey Brady with his second goal of the season. Now Clayton State in trouble. They've got to try and get something on Kendrick here. The Lakers haven't even had a shot. Two shots for North Greenville, and, well, both
found the net.
We've seen what both of those have done, so pretty low stat line, but heavily in favor of NGU right now is foul going to be whistled against Dwamina. Or no, it's against North Greenville. It's against Brady. So a free kick for the Lakers, who find themselves down by two and no shots on the stat sheet. Coming in for Clayton State, I mean, Larry Frere has had a very strong start to the season in the net. Has a .82 and 82% save percentage, and teams are only scoring 1.42 goals per game, and North Greenville's already beat the average.
And did it in less than 20 minutes at that.
Kendrick's numbers, he's got a 79% save percentage, team scoring just over two goals against the sophomore keeper out of Cleveland, Georgia. Chance here for Clayton State working into the box and once again rejected by the defensive back line. And head coach Pete Peterson for Clayton State recognizing that needs to get something jump started on the field. Two substitutes await on the sideline for the next stoppage. And ball out of bounds, back to North Greenville. Very wonderful night here out at Pepsi Stadium. Hurricane Florence has either dissipated or moved on, finally got out of the area. And now folks just trying to clean up and get things back to the way things were. Did have a little bit of rain and a good fair share of wind, depending on where you were in the upstate, if you were up here.
And thoughts and prayers going off to everybody in the coast as that one's picked up.
Ooh, Kendrick had to jump up for it. Clayton State did have traffic in the box, but the air traffic controller, Noah Kendrick, able to pick his way through it.
Nice slide tackle coming in right there.
And you're absolutely right. It should be North Greenville ball. Folks trying to clean up along the coastline there, especially around Myrtle Beach, Wilmington corridor. And if you want to help those folks, Red Cross and Salvation Army still accepting donations or your relief agency of choice. So help these people get their lives back to some state of normalcy. Here at Pepsi Stadium, North Greenville leads 2-0, 25 minutes to go until half. And Clayton State might have a shot here as they will roll a slow dribbler. Great defense by Dylan Erkins, who was able to hang with Dwamina. And just a slow trickler that Kendrick was able to pick up.
And you got to get a sense that Clayton State is getting a little frustrated here. You come in, you know the history of this matchup. You know what's going on. That one is sent up and onside.
And Roberson just can't get to it in time, but here comes a rebound shot. What a stop by the keeper. And Frere bails himself out with a deflection. Not one, but two chances there for North Greenville. Roberson on the first. I think it was Gareth Green who came flying in, and he couldn't get it.
And then you got to look back. Dusan Stankovic on that back line cleared it out from off the deflection. But great opportunity and just what a great timed run from Nick Roberson. That was – you couldn't have done that any better.
And North Greenville is looking at 3-0 all the way. And right there, that is a prime example of what North Greenville is going to have to do this match. Time your runs and try and get behind the – Lakers defense, catch them sleeping. And now the offside flag will go up against number 14, Hector Gutierrez, well offsides, off the line. Those two substitutes did make their way in for Clayton State. Carlos Narano came in, and Dean Foster for Stankovic.
And picked off in the midfield again, North Greenville.
QK Molina there, the junior from Manizales, Colombia.
Shook off his man, but another Clayton State defender comes up with it.
Greenville not done yet, though. Casey Brady got it. And a long pass lining up. Bounced off a Laker defender. Takes a sideways hop. Good Crusader roll. And a foul against the Lakers coming up.
And it just looked like off that sideways spin, just an inadvertent handball. But again, North Greenville, an opportunity on a free kick. Just scored on one 10 minutes ago.
And that was Casey Brady. And here is Kike Molina lining up for this kick. He's got Robertson to his right. And waiting for the signal from the referee. Signals for play to begin, and Roberson will take the kick, lining up to the right side, headed away, and North Greenville's going to let that roll out for a corner kick.
First one of the game for either team. North Greenville already scoring off one set piece and just earning a corner off a second one.
Now, some good news if you're a Lakers fan. You did get a shot, and it was on goal, but North Greenville three shots now, two of those on goal, and those two did score. Kick coming in, and it goes right to the post, and it's stopped. That was Gus Johnson who got a foot to it, and Frayer has figured out how to make the stops, and Larry Frayer making the stops.
And Gus Johnson just getting an opportunity, and now Clayton State going to be whistled offside, and they can't believe it.
Brad Kay too far out in front of the flag. And the referee not having any of it from Metro Tarunen. Long pass looking for Robertson over his head, and don't think Clayton State's going to be able to get to that one. And it is out of bounds. It will be Clayton State ball anyway, though. Yeah, looks like a handball we called there against North Greenville after it took a bounce up into the hand of Segovia. No free kick coming up here for Clayton State with just over 20 minutes to go. Clock stops with 20:05. Waiting on the resumption of play, Segovia having a talk with the referee. Clayton State taking her time with this free kick.
Had to wait for resumption of play from the referee, but back to action now.
They did the little stutter step on it. You normally see those on penalty kicks. That was a very interesting strategy play. As here is Foster. Foster trying to outmaneuver the defense, takes a strike, and Kendrick comes over to make the save as that one's curling in toward the right post. And now Clayton State, this should be a corner kick for the Lakers.
And they will be rewarded with one. Is that incredible vision from Kendrick to realize where that was going to curl to, left foot, going to curve in back towards the near post.
A lot of English put on that ball. It's near side corner here for Clayton State. Goal late in this first half would do wonders for the confidence of the Lakers. North Greenville striking twice as a high cross that will find help on the left side. It is Jordan Knight. Looks like Jordan Knight trying to get in the box. Can't do it. Rejected out by Segovia.
Now North Greenville with a chance on counter, but it's going to be taken away.
Jordan Knight, number five out there, the defender, had the best look at it. And another Lakers foul.
Segovia getting tripped up, and North Greenville going to take possession back. But, Gray, you just get a sense that North Greenville firing on all cylinders, and it's refreshing to see for a team that's more or less had some struggles over the last couple seasons.
And they've got to, as Clayton State behind the defense. Lots of tangle up and a collision. And we might have a card here.
Going to be out of the box, but it will be a yellow card.
And that is against North Greenville. Can't tell the defender who it was. But that is a yellow card and a great opportunity here. North Greenville just avoiding the penalty kick, as it was again Dwamina who was almost behind the defense.
And
a yellow card going against Jake Quinn. So he will be on the watch for the rest of the match.
And there's nothing really much anyone could have done there other than back off and try and play it a little differently. But when you're that close in on the goal, it's bound to happen every now and then. And luckily for North Greenville, going to be set up outside the box and not within it.
So either Tarunen or Dromina on the free kick. And here comes Dwamina on the strike. Bounced off a defender. Clayton State still with it, though. North Greenville chasing it out of the box. Now Tarunen has it. He'll put it back into play, and it's sent packing by Erkins. North Greenville on the counter.
A lot of space on the left side.
They will go there, and turning on the Jecks, it is Zach Baker. Baker now pulls up short, fires to the right side. They've got a man open on the header. Stopped by Frere. Rebound shot goes wide left. No good.
And North Greenville just continuing to fire on all cylinders, do everything they can towards that offensive side of the field. And that, don't let it go slip your mind that that literally just came off of a block within their own 18-yard box.
Kyle Knopp will sub in here for Rolando Macias. Knopp, a sophomore out of Franklin, North Carolina. That's around the Murphy area, just south of Bryson City, Dillsboro, if you're taking the scenic way to Chattanooga. Also, side note for your curious fact finders coming up after this is Clayton State pressing into the North Greenville box. Dromina is there on the left side. Brady comes in and will send to packing. I believe the only Crystal Burger restaurant in the entire state of North Carolina is in that Murphy area.
That's a big fact right there.
Now trying the right side edge. Right wing chased out of bounds. Still in play, now just kicked out. And on this side of the corner flag, so a throw in. And the referee motioning, it's North Greenville ball. Lots of communication going on there, out there for both teams. That is a good thing to hear. And Clayton State again trying the right side. They've got open space. Number 14, Gutierrez, lining up the shot into the box for Dromina. Kendrick with the save.
And Kendrick getting some love from his teammates on the bench. Nice play the last couple minutes out of the goalkeeper.
Yeah, a couple of nice saves. He's got a pair of them. Then again, Larry Frere, he's got two of them as well. And a right wing pass deflected, and Clayton State trying to turn it upfield. 15 minutes to go here in the first half. North Greenville leads 2-0. Nice through pass, but it's picked up by North Greenville and sent out of bounds to stall the attack.
And that's the thing that That's the thing I've noticed more than anything else. North Greenville, you know, typically soccer teams in any, like, dire situation are going to kick it out of bounds and just force a reset. That's only, like, the third or fourth time North Greenville's done that this entire match. Most times finding a player in the midfield towards the sidelines and then running it up.
And this one's going to land back at the feet here. Strike and a goal for Clayton State. No flags up. That one is good. Referee says signal. Good. And the goal coming there for Clayton State's number 9, that was Dean Foster.
And Kendrick and a couple other Crusaders wondering how that's not whistled a handball. Looked like it might have come down off the forearm of a Laker, but regardless, the goal is going to stand. And Clayton State cuts the deficit back to one goal.
Second goal of the season there for Dean Foster, and quite the confidence boost for Clayton State. Able to cut into the lead. Now the offense for the Lakers might get going. But here comes Roberson. Picks up the pass. Tries to get it past the goalkeeper. And he and Frere collide. What's the call going to be?
It's going to be outside the box. But more than likely, that's going to be a yellow card towards the goalkeeper. And that's a huge loss to North Greenville if he's going to have to come out of this game.
Yeah, Roberson's still down on the turf. Training crew making his way out there.
Just an unfortunate play. The ball took a bounce right on the edge of the 18-yard box, so goalkeeper can't touch it with his hands, has to go up with the body.
Now hopefully, Roberson just got the wind knocked out of him. Did take a pretty good lick from the Lakers keeper. Frere out of a junior out of Dalton, Georgia, just south of, well, on I-75.
And a red card shown to the goalkeeper.
That's a turn of twist and turn there.
Clayton State going to be down to 10 men and without their starting goalkeeper at that.
They do have two backup goalies, a freshman, or two freshmen. And Larry Frere is taking his gloves off. He is out of the game.
And now it's going to be interesting to see who's going to get the call up to go play goalkeeper.
Looks like number one, Kari Pustinen, starting to strap on his shoes. So it might be the freshman from Finland, his go.
Roberson getting checked on by the athletic staff, just making absolutely sure he's going to be okay before they let him back in the game.
It's a big blow here to Clayton State, losing your starting keeper just after you get a goal that really brought you back into this thing. The offense for Clayton State has not been able to get going, but Dwamina trying to get going. Instead, it was Dean Foster who scores the goal. And
that's just a complete shift of momentum. North Greenville tackling it for the first two goals and through the first almost 30 minutes of this game. Until recently, Clayton State scores a goal, flips the momentum back to them, but almost immediately afterwards, getting a red card to your goalkeeper.
And it will be Kari Pustin in his turn, so he will take net.
And that's not exactly how you expect a freshman to get the nod, but now it's going to be up to him to keep Clayton State in this game and keep North Greenville out of the net.
And for the moment, while Nick Roberson continues to go through the protocol on the sideline from the athletic training staff, it will be number 14, Kaletso Matate, who will come in for him. Now, Matate did not start, but will come in here with 13:53 left to go in the half. And a pair of goals for him on the season for North Greenville leads the team. And he leads the team also with 4 points. And we're ready here on the free kick. Lined up and scored.
No contest. Left foot straight to the top of the net. 3-1 North Greenville.
No chance there for Pustinen to make the stop there. And it was Gareth Green, the freshman from Navarre, Florida, but out of Wade Hampton High School. So another general on the field tonight for North Greenville. Puts him up 3-1.
And this is going to be the third appearance for Pustinen after giving up that goal. That's going to be his fourth goal against in just over 101 minutes played. Does have 10 saves and one loss to his record. 22nd shot faced.
And how about a nice celebration there for the first goal of the season for Gareth Green. And now Clayton State getting a touch to the ball, but now that's pulled away. Gareth Green, nice footwork over the right side. Lots of room there for Zach Baker. Baker with a defender on him, intercepted, and the Lakers trying to clear it away. They will do so.
And it's going to be an interesting play here for North Greenville. They're going to end up having either an extra man on attack or an extra man to play defense, depending on the play. But it's going to force Clayton State's midfield to play more of both than they normally would.
Long shot lined up, bounced off the goalie. Kendrick's got to make the save. He can't do it. Now he's got to get back in net. Here comes a chance lined up for the Lakers. They can't get it in. One defender's tripped up. Nice deflection there and cleared out. Played. Tarunen had a wide open look at it. Could not convert.
And the pace is absolutely picked up in this one, just back and forth like basketball.
No whistle there as the North Greenville player takes a tumble. Again, Clayton State down to 10 men. Starting goalkeeper red carded with 14 minutes left to go in the half, and Clayton State going all out. They're not playing like they only have 10 men out there. And now here's Matate down the left wing and out of bounds. Kletso Matate, a sophomore from Brakpan, South Africa. North Greenville with the advantage in goals and right now for the rest of the match, players on the field.
Well, you'd hope.
Yeah, you would think.
Never say for sure until that final whistle blows.
You don't think I know that? Pulling for Tennessee and all. Sometimes the game's even not over when the game isn't even over when the final whistle blows. Here's Brady right wing. Brady's got space. And he'll set it up. Cross into the box. The back heel shot, no good.
Now North Greenville absolutely does have the offensive numbers now. It's not even a question. Obviously, there's one more person on the field for NGU, but they have to resist the temptation to try these trick shot types, and just these ridiculous, awe-inspiring goals, and just try and keep with the game plan even though there's one less man against you.
And there will be goal number two for Clayton State, and it was Tarunen. Gets the cross into the box from number 18, Narano. So Clayton State down a man. Doesn't matter. They score again.
And you're just going to look and see this attack. It's these midfield. You're just going to see this attack come out of this midfield. They're going to come out of everywhere. These midfielders are going to get overworked throughout the rest of this game, but they are going to rush to every attack and rush back to every defense.
Well, now it's 3-2, five total goals scored. All in the first half here. Not even done with the first half of play. Still have 10 minutes to go.
It's been less than 35 minutes.
What's the Tecmo Bowl line for a soccer game? And North Greenville's not done yet. Here comes a shot up. Deflected out. Casey Brady running in. He can't get a foot to it. Zach Baker will try, and he scores.
Baker from distance.
Ooh, yeah. From downtown against the Lakers. Pretty sure that's not the first time that's been said. Zach Baker, his second goal of the game.
Incredible shot.
Well, it seems just right when Clayton State is able to get back into things, North Greenville says, uh-uh.
And that was 28 from about 28. And, you know, I get this sinking feeling that they're not done yet.
Now, they've still got plenty of time. Baker now in contention for a hat trick. When was the last time North Greenville scored a hat trick in a match?
Last one I can remember, Opiola Loco did one on debut.
Now Crusaders looking for their fifth goal. Yes, their fifth goal of the match. Brady works it across midfield. And Clayton State had to change up their defensive doctrine. And so far appears to be working, but don't tell Kike Molina that. Baker in the middle again, working it forward. Gareth Green tripped up and finally has it stripped away after four Lakers were in the way, as here is Brad Kay, and he has pulled it back. Here goes to Stankovic. Segovia, and we'll get a foot onto it and cleared away by Quinn. Out of bounds, back to Clayton State. Lakers have had to change up their offensive doctrine as well, and they have asked, looks like the freshman Brad Kay out of Manchester, England, will become the forward attacker to try and press. They started the match with Siobhan Blake working the right wing, and Brad Kay hanging more back at a midfielder position, but you know, Brad Kay stepping up on the attacking line. Throw in for Clayton State. Still 7:50 to go in the first half. And here is Tarunen. Chipping it up, and they have a man open. Is he onside? Yes, he is. Shot into the box. Deflected, but not enough. Clayton State with the shot. Nothing going there, and cleared away. Now North Greenville on the counter. So far, so good for the Crusaders. Upfield, Gareth Green in traffic. Feeds it through. Matate trying to outrun the defender and can't do it. And it's bounced off of Matate back to number 10, Molina. Molina back trying to get it back to Matate, who's stripped of it. Out of bounds, back to the Lakers. North Greenville could time it right. That Molina-Matate connection might be a good one to try and hook up with on that left wing again, especially now that Clayton State is down to 10 men. Long pass, though, and a man behind the defense. And right to Kendrick as Brad Kay turning on the Jets. Too far in front of him, though. A lot of coaching instruction from Bill Martin going on the sideline, telling his guys, you'll have openings now. You'll have openings in the defense, or at least bigger ones than what you had before. Brad Kay lining up to the middle of the field. Gareth Green to Brady. North Greenville able to pull possession. Now back to Green. Green lining up a shot and wide left. Guys love the encouragement now.
And Coach Martin on the sideline just agging his team on.
Shoot it, shoot it.
Why not?
He did. Green had the opening and not able to adjust the open or the angle. As Ben McKay, freshman out of Watkinsville, Georgia, will come in for the Crusaders, and Brady we'll take a seat. North Greenville pressing again. Gareth Green puts pressure on the freshman keeper who skies at the midfield. And lots of good hops there from Clayton State, able to find Dean Foster. I guess tangled up with Gus Johnson. Now cross into the box, the Lakers deflect it out. And the Crusaders on the clear. There is McKay with his first touch. And that goal scored earlier to get the second goal on the board for Clayton State. That was Metro Tarunin, his first goal of the season. Less than now 5 minutes to go until half. North Greenville leads 4-2. Zach Baker looking for a hat trick for the match. Part of the headlines through this first half. Clayton State playing with 10 men. Starting goalkeeper Larry Frere red carded with 14 minutes to go after a collision with Nick Roberson, who is on the bench sitting up, is still talking with the training staff.
Did have an ice pack to his face a couple minutes ago. Was looks not too worse for the wear, but we'll find out.
Zach Baker was lining up for the shot here. Now they try to go here and deflect it out. McKay in the middle of the field there, blocked out for the corner.
And nice play by Pustin and diving to his left and punching that out of midair, but going to end up as a corner for North Greenville. And in no real hurry to take it, two-goal lead. 3 minutes to play in the first half.
Yeah, trying to wind some clock down to send it to the break. Clayton State's going to have their work cut out for them as the cross will come in. Someone jumped earlier for North Greenville. Rebound shot drifts wide left. Like the aggressiveness, although the one hopper right there to number six. So that was number 16, Kyle Knopp, who came running in for it. Sends it wide. Now just over 2 minutes to go. One, maybe two more good attacks for either team. The throw-in coming up for the Lakers. Throwing for the Lakers. Offside flag goes up. Or nope, that was a foul called from the referee in the middle of the field. So that was actually a foul against North Greenville, free kick. Ninety seconds to go. Clayton State trying to get a goal to take into halftime with them. Down by two, strike in, and right to Kendrick falls on it.
But all credit going to Clayton State, was on goal. Still firing.
The spin there, able to connect on these high kicks. 1 minute to left in the first half. North Greenville with it. Do they try and press and go for the goal or just try and ride it out in the final 50? Crusaders across midfield, back to the defensive line. Not under any hurry to press the attack. Now they turn on the Jets. Left wing begins moving up through the middle of the field and right to Pustinen. And now Clayton State with 30 seconds to go. They'll have a good shot left as they are already down into the corner. And North Greenville will send it back to Kendrick. Kendrick gets it out of there at the last second. Clayton State gets it back with now 15 seconds to go.
North Greenville playing really loose with that two-goal lead.
Less than 10 seconds now, and that will put an end to that attack. North Greenville with Gus Johnson clears it out, and one more strike up in the air, and easy save by Pustinen. That will take us to the break. Quite a first half for North Greenville Clayton State. The Crusaders outscoring the Lakers 4-2 as Clayton State playing with 10 men after the red card against starting goalkeeper Larry Frere. So both teams will head to their respective corners of the field as we are at half. Your halftime score, North Greenville 4, Clayton State 2. We'll step away with them for a timeout and bring you back for more action here from Pepsi Stadium on the campus of North Greenville University. Well, quite a first half it has been as we get ready for the second between North Greenville and Clayton State. 4-2, North Greenville leads it. So we take a look at the final, or not the final, the halftime stats for you. 2 goals for Clayton State, 4 for North Greenville. No assists have been put up on the board yet, but the big line is in the shots on goal. 7 out of 11 for North Greenville, and for Clayton State it is 6 out of 9. North Greenville leads corner kicks 2-1, and 4 saves. Noah Kendrick with 4. 3 total for the 2 goalkeepers for Clayton State. Reason why we say 2 for the 2 goalkeepers is Larry Frere red carded out of the match with about 14 minutes to go, and Kerry Pustinen came in to take his place for the rest of the match.
And it's just ever since that red card went up on the board, it's just been back and forth all the way. It was a 2-1 game with 14 minutes to go. And now we're sitting here, 3 total goals scored since that red card incident, and no signs of slowing down at all.
Zach Baker is on the quest for a hat trick. He scored the opening goal for North Greenville just under 4 minutes into the game, and then closed out the scoring in the first half with a goal just past the 35-minute mark. Casey Brady has also tallied up one. Gareth Green tallied up his first goal of the season. Your goal scorers for the match for Clayton State is Dean Foster and Metro Turunen. So you got to wonder at this point, what does Clayton State really want out of the second half?
They're going to want to try and make this deficit as small as possible. They're going to try and win this game. It's going to be extremely difficult with one less man on the field, but they've already proven that they can score with only 10 men. But if they're going to get this, they're going to have to do what North Greenville's done. And you look down this order, Gareth Green, Kike Molina, Casey Brady, Jake Quinn, Zach Baker, and Ben McKay. So 6 different Crusaders have taken a shot on goal, and only 3 in that category towards Clayton State.
And something North Greenville has done very strongly that I have been saying they need to do more and more, and it looks like it is starting to build up some pressure. Head coach Bill Martin, this team is taking more shots, and they are looking good doing it.
Absolutely, and everything has gone North Greenville's way, save one yellow card issued earlier to Jake Quinn. One kind of flukish goal that led to a 4-2 game now, but 45 minutes to play. Clayton State down a man. Going to see if they can try and close this deficit or if North Greenville is just going to keep piling on the goals.
And history's on the line here. North Greenville has never beaten Clayton State. The Lakers hold a perfect 4-0 advantage in the times these teams have met up, twice in 2004, and then once in 2006, once in 2007. This is their first trip to Tigerville in 12 years, the first time they've played in 11, as the horn sounds. Ready to start the second half. Clayton State ready to go. North Greenville ready to go. North Greenville now defending the left end goal. Clayton State defending the right end goal. 4-2, the advantage for North Greenville, seeking their first win over the Lakers of Clayton State out of the Peach Belt.
And Gray, we kind of glossed over one of those stats that's kind of bizarre. When you see a team that's down a man, you don't really see too many more shots on goal. But only trailing North Greenville by 1, North Greenville just been more efficient, 4 of 7 to 2 of 6.
So let's see if the intensity is still there here in this half. What headlines will we have for the second half? Clayton State trying to turn it upfield. Noah Kendrick has looked very good in goal as the ball will roll out of bounds. And North Greenville gets it back, so the first possession of the half for Clayton State will last 29 seconds.
And you have to give some credit out to Kerry Pustinen coming in and essentially what amounts to an emergency goalkeeping situation. You're really not going to get put in unless it's a dire situation. And you red card out a goalie, so...
Here's Matate looking for the opening. Didn't have it.
And Pustinen forced into action. Only has 1 goal scored against him on 2 shots on goal, but the first one coming literally as he was coming into the game off the free kick from the red card.
And that doesn't give enough time for a keeper to adjust. He's got to adjust, settle in, and who knows how long that can take. 10, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, an entire match, who knows. But, yeah, it's like a backup quarterback in football. You never know when the starter's helmet's going to come off and you have to come in for what might be one play, but that could be the one play that wins the ball game. Free kick coming up here for North Greenville off the Lakers foul.
I'll tell you some irony coming out of this. Spent a little bit of day watching videos on NHL emergency goalkeepers, and it's the exact same situation coming out of this.
High strike over to the right side, headed out by Clayton State. Well, glad you did mention hockey. Not too much longer. We'll have local hockey back with the Swab Rabbits.
Opening night, October the 12th, downtown at the Bonsport Wellness Arena.
Or the Well. And now a high strike here for Clayton State, and that's headed out by NGU. Kept in play. Lakers keep it alive. Still waiting on those fall temps to show up as well. Kind of getting ill of these 90-degree days in mid-September.
Slowly but surely, they're coming out.
Clayton State still looking for the cross here into the box. Lakers back out of the corner. Lining up to the middle. Here comes a strike, and it's over the crossbar. No good. Coming off the foot of Tim Nusesser. We were discussing in that first half, wondering when the last North Greenville hat trick was, when that occurred, and we now have that answer. And it was last hat trick for North Greenville was October the 11th of last year, and it was Ope Olaloko who scored it.
So for once, I guessed a stat right.
How about that? And another hard foul. Also against Clayton State.
And Dylan Erkins went down hard off that play.
After he collided with Kwaku Dwamina.
And that's the second different Crusader that's been down in a heap of pain today.
Nick Roberson did get treated on the sideline, and I believe he's either put on a blue sub jersey or has just put back on the warm-up shirt. I don't think we will see him for the rest of the match.
If the match were closer and with more time on the clock, maybe you're pushing the issue, but you saw him on the sidelines and coming up, going through concussion protocol and everything to make sure he's okay, and better to not test the issue if there's no real reason to.
So, but Roberson was okay. Erkins did get up under his own power and already working hard again for North Greenville with the ball here. Erkins lining it up over to Matate. And Matate, well guarded, kept it in play, but that one's going to roll slow to Pustinen, who will just heave it back into play. Got an arm. That one will roll all the way to midfield. And Clayton State's going to pick it up and run with it. Lining up over to Tarunen. And now back to Nusesser, graduate player out of Germany. Bad Burlberg, Germany. And now Gareth Green pulling up.
And Gareth Green just looks like he took an extra step on that and caught a cramp. Looks like he's going to be okay.
Try and walk that one off. Offside flag goes up on the far side, and the Lakers are called for it.
And a nice trap play there by Erkins.
It's their fourth time they've been called offside.
Erkins and a couple other Crusaders doing the old trap play. Run with the offensive player. Then you just pull back as he keeps running on the pass.
Clayton State brings pressure against Kendrick. Line drive kicks it out of there. Nice one-hopper over the head of Green. Gareth Green. Doesn't look like he's showing any ill effects from that cramp. Nothing doing on the attack. Tarunen at midfield, able to intercept. Now North Greenville scored 3:43 into the match, and no goals yielded yet this second half. Clayton State trying to get something started the left wing, and that one is high and outside. Back to North Greenville.
And you saw right there just a nod from between Jack Stevens and Jordan Knight, realizing that one of them wasn't on the same page. Just checking it out and trying not to make that happen again.
And if you just so happen to be wondering about the soccer games that were rained out over the weekend, as substitute coming in, Zach Baker will check back in. And that was Roberson. Roberson was out there. He just came off the field.
Yeah, just testing him out for a couple minutes, it looks like.
Well, I guess that's one way to see if you're okay. So Roberson did get some playing time there in the second half. Zach Baker can begin his quest for the hat trick as soon as North Greenville gets the ball back. Good pass there to Tarunen. Thought about lining up the shot. Scoots it to the right side. Kendrick comes up and makes the save. And he's down.
Sacrifice the body to make the save. And he's still rolling a little bit. Trying to collect himself. The trainer's going to come out and the clock's going
to
get stopped.
Yeah, they're going to have to stop play for this. Well, they take a look at the starting goalkeeper now for North Greenville, who's injured on the field, but this stoppage will carry us into a timeout. But last Friday, North Greenville was supposed to play a doubleheader against Emmanuel College out of Franklin Springs, Georgia. And if you're wondering about the makeup dates for that, we have one for the women's soccer match. That will be played tomorrow evening at 7. Not sure about the makeup for the men's game. Don't see that on the schedule, but I do know that the women's soccer game against a match against Emmanuel will be made up tomorrow night at 7. Well, Kendrick's back up and will stay in the box here. Now North Greenville, Gareth Green looking for something on the right side. Now back to the middle, deflected out. Clayton State able to get in the way of it. And now Clayton State with a man behind the defense and
caught off again.
Fifth offside call against the Lakers. North Greenville is warming up some of their backup keepers. They do have number 0, Tate McMurray, number 1, Dawson Martin, listed as goalkeepers on the roster. You've also got number 34, Giannis Malud.
You look at the talent up and down this board on this team, and Gray, you only see, what is that, 4 seniors on the entire roster, and the majority are freshmen and sophomore.
It's almost the same script for the women's team. Young teams trying to restock after of course, a graduation turnover and things like that. So young teams here for North Greenville, and always a struggle to try and keep experienced players on the field. So the young players that are out there for North Greenville now, they're going to have to learn quick and learn to adapt on the fly.
And it's always interesting, especially in collegiate sports, because you have that 4-year NCAA ruling. You only have a total of 4 years to play these guys at most.
North Greenville might have a chance here. It's Zach Baker leading the charge out front, and he gets beat by Gutierrez. Clayton State still not playing like they're playing with only 10 men, as they had a man open on the right side and he pulled up. as he might have been offside.
Flag never went up, and that's why he was kind of frustrated.
So now North Greenville can begin again. Number 13, Eric Gonzalez, freshman out of Taylor's Eastside High School. Home of the Eagles. North Greenville having trouble getting out of their defensive part of the field. And finally, Kike Molina puts it up. Gareth Green takes a tumble. Clayton State will get it back. Now they're trying something. Deflected away. And they'll pick it up with Jack Stevens, number 21. Freshman out of Brisbane, Australia for the Lakers. Tarunen slides and can't keep it in. Almost got to wonder what has happened. Six goals scored in the first half total. Nothing so far for the second half.
And it looks like just it's taken quite a while, but team's starting to figure one another out defensively. And no real attack being able to be mounted right now.
A good crowd showing up here at Pepsi Stadium for this night match. Temperatures have cooled off nicely since the sun has gone down. And lots of throw-ins. Throw-ins have dominated the second half. North Greenville trying. Gareth Green cut away. The Lakers get to it. Now North Greenville gets it back. Dean Foster there. Been a while since we called his name. Set up pass looking for Green. Put away by Dwamina.
And back heel back in.
And pushed back out by Pustinen. Also want to shout out there to Baylor Asher, number 19, a freshman defender out of Sonoya, Georgia. And North Greenville defense tested here again by Dwamina. Has been a thorn in their side all night, but they have relatively held him in check. It's been Tarunen who has it that North Greenville has had the problem with, as he'll feed it through to Dwamina. Dwamina lining up the shot. He's got him beat, and it's deflected out of the last second by Erkins.
And it's not every day that a red card to the goalkeeper is not beneficial to you, but in some way this goalkeeper switch has benefited Clayton State.
It's one of those rare things where you see a team that they're playing aggressive, and it's almost like it has caught North Greenville off guard, but they have adapted well enough that the Crusaders haven't let up a goal yet, but they haven't been able to score any more insurance. Here's Green again. Swings it left side, cut away by Jordan Knight. Out of Javea, Spain. And another Crusader is down as Clayton State pushes the attack.
And they're going to stop the clock again.
And he's pulled up. And
which one is that?
I hate to say it, but it looks like Gareth Green, who pulled up earlier, holding his right, what might be his right hamstring.
And it is. Green going to come out. Will Moy going to come in. But that's the second time in the last 10 minutes Gareth Green's gone down.
The junior, number 8, Will Moy, checks in, and Green will take a seat. That's a loss up front for North Greenville if he can't get back into the match. So Clayton State, and their endurance proving to be the toughest thing to get around for North Greenville. Clayton State with a chance somewhere in the corner and finally lost out of bounds and back to NGU.
Come on.
We still got about half an hour as a dangerous pass. North Greenville sling it around in front of their goal. Clayton State with three attackers forward. You got to get it out of there. And they finally do. And now it's sent right back in by a new Sesser. New Sesser again. Over to the right. Clayton State with room. Shot in. Deflected out. And Eric Gonzalez able to get it out the furthest. All the way to midfield. Gonzalez looking to the left. Headed on by Clayton State right to Pustinen.
And North Greenville just spending a lot of time in the defending half. That's something they haven't really had to do much of the match.
There's still plenty of time left on this clock, and Clayton State, despite playing with 10 men, they still fully expect to have walk out of here with a victory. North Greenville brings to the right side. Will Moy with his touch. Erkins down the right wing. He's open, lining up the cross in the box. Hopped off a defender, but right to another North Greenville player. Lines up the shot, and it rolls in off the deflection. Goal scored for NGU, their fifth of the game, and that was for Ben McKay.
The freshman from Watkinsville, Georgia, adding his name to the score sheet.
And what a job there by Erkins to find the open man in the box. McKay putting it just to enough to the left of Pustinen to catch him off the mark and gets it off the deflection. It's 5-2, and North Greenville cruising, trying to get their first win over Clayton State. And Clayton State right back to work. Dwamina, right side.
And this already the biggest deficit that Clayton State's faced the entire game. Looking to try and bring it back to two.
Whenever North Greenville scores, as that one goes wide left, Clayton State's been able to score just a few minutes after, as Dean Foster trying to line up another one for his second of the game. As Ben McKay scores his first goal of the season, increasing the lead to 3 for North Greenville. 28 minutes left to go in the half.
First goal of season, first goal of career.
On the goal kick, it will trail past halfway. And number 13, Eric Gonzalez, wanting his goal. Now Will Moy tried to get it deflected, couldn't do it. And Dolmina had him running circles there as he went back to Charunin.
And Gray, you've got to wonder, with the pace of play, that one's going to dribble out to Kendrick. The pace of play that's been going on since the red card was shown, what this game could have been beforehand was a 2-1 game and pretty scrappy and offensive on either side when it was 11-on-11.
Clayton State definitely had the advantage in speed. Now it's starting to shift into the endurance part of the game, and I still believe Clayton State has the edge right now, but down a man, North Greenville has been able to stick with them as this game has worn on, so that's definitely a good thing. The Crusaders not getting tired out there. They're able to stick with Clayton State, a little bit quicker team out there right now. But it's with a three-goal advantage right now, 27 minutes, it looks pretty. North Greenville, all you got to do is just keep matching the pace.
And looks like number 2, Bradley Jennings, the sophomore from Asheville, North Carolina, getting set to sub in.
And it looks like here comes Segovia off. He has been out there for quite some time in this match for North Greenville, most if not all of it.
And this is going to end up being a very good game for Bill Martin and the rest of the coaching staff. The guys that are sitting on the bench, normally not getting a lot of playing time in favor of some older and more experienced players. getting their chance to shine here in a 5-2 ball game with over 25 minutes still to play.
North Greenville has been able to get the offense going and keep it going. That's especially something that they're going to have to focus on, as it's going to be a brutal schedule for the next few games, as Clayton State once again working down the right wing, Dromina, deflected and cleared out by NGU. North Greenville men's soccer, 3 road games coming up, as Will Moy trying again for that goal. After tonight for North Greenville, it's on the road to Barton, September 22nd, at Bob Jones on the 24th, and then at King on the 29th. So 3 games in a week before you return back home here to take on the Nighthawks of North Georgia. By then, we're into October. Clayton State pressing up. Stankovic back to Turunen. Jack Stevens, Turunen again. Turunen trying to find the open space. North Greenville, 3 defenders, 3 midfielders now dropping back. And the chip up does find help. Now here comes Kendrick off his mark to make the save in front of a running Turunen. Brad Kay has been the guy ever since that red card momentum shift happened. The Lakers have tried to move Kay up and get him going. North Greenville has had a cover for him ever since. And here on the right wing, Erkins picks it up. Cuts inside. Fires it to the middle. And good defensive play there from the Lakers. Dean Foster again.
And no quitting. This North Greenville team have a 3-goal lead, and they're still trying to step into passing lanes and create opportunities.
Dean Foster, after scoring a goal, one of the 2 goals for Clayton State, is listed as a forward, but has had to shift to lots of defender roles. The junior from Johannesburg, South Africa.
And Nick Robertson getting set to check back in. Think he's good to go?
I think he might be. Coach, put me in. Even coaching from the sideline a little bit. Trying to get the ball over here to Eric Gonzalez. Now Gonzalez looking down for Cameron Ward, who fires it in and deflected out. That looked like a 6 to me. Clayton State able to clear it out, though, so that attack comes to an end as we're past halfway in the second half. Getting close to the 70th minute. And a heavy whistle. I didn't see anything. Referee walking over to one of the far side defenders for Clayton State, and a vivid discussion taking place. No card's been issued yet.
Not yet, but looking like he wasn't liking the conversations going on behind on the back line. Going to issue a warning, tell them to just stop. But if that
settle down,
but if that starts again, don't be surprised if some late game yellows start coming out. And after a frustrating game for Clayton State, that wouldn't be all the most shocking thing today.
Good through ball here, looking for Cam Ward, and Bustenin comes to sky it up. Brad Kay, the closest to it, 3 defenders for North Greenville, and Kendrick just puts it all to bed.
And Kendrick, having to simultaneously see where that ball was going to drop and see where he was going to come down, because if he's holding that in his hands outside the 18-yard box, that's immediate possession back to the Lakers.
Kendrick's already taken a good lick today, so you don't want to sacrifice your keeper to another body shot. And a foul here against Clayton State. North Greenville free kick. Thank you for joining us here on the North Greenville Sports Network, now powered by the Conference Carolinas Digital Network. Streaming live to you on all your smart TV devices and things affiliated with that. Throw in here for the Lakers. And they will turned it over, and then they got it right back. Stankovic battles hard and pushes it back over to midfield to Jordan Knight. Right wing possession over there. Will Moy again, he'll bring the pressure. Chipped up looking for Ben Kay. And now here comes Dwamina. North Greenville has had Dwamina running around in circles. No outlets through for him to get to. 70 minutes down, 20 to go. North Greenville leads 5-2. And the offensive shootout of the night. Had Eric Gonzalez off to the races there, but Clayton State getting to it. Ever since the start of the second half, Clayton State's been able to get to the box. But that's where the North Greenville defense has put on the brakes. Going to be tested here. Domina looking through. They've got two through and a shot missed. And it was, I believe it was Stankovic who put it up. Or no, that must be an eight. That must be Connor Atkinson who was over there. Now it's a single-digit number. And if he would turn around, I could see it. There you go. It is number nine. That was Dean Falster who was up front on that shot.
A left-footed shot, just not really having a chance at all. A little bit of English too much.
North Greenville at a disadvantage there. Two attackers versus four defenders. And Columbus State's going to win that battle, and a foul against North Greenville there. A little bit of pushing and shoving between attacker and defender. Now, almost looks like a line change lining up here on the North Greenville side. Three up waiting to come in.
Yeah, Gareth Green, James Segovia, and Nick Robertson all standing on the sideline and waiting.
Robertson's been standing there for almost 10 minutes, it seems like. Might get their chance here. Ball rolls out of bounds offside. And Robertson in, Green in.
And excuse me, that's Kike Molina, not James Segovia.
So Moy is off, Gonzalez is off, and Ward is off.
And now, speak of the devil, James Segovia is going to go stand and get ready to sub in at the next stoppage.
You're a prophetic there. No whistle as North Greenville takes a tumble to the turf. Player over there taking a tumble. Clayton State back the other way. Jack Stevens looking for help. Tarunen back to Stevens. Stevens, two defenders on him. Bradley Jennings there on the coverage.
Bradley Jennings really spreading out through the midfield. Applying a lot of defense that's helping out North Greenville maintain this lead.
Trying to boom one downfield to find Tim Nusesser. It's too far in front of him. Goal kick for Kendrick. Well, at one time in this game, North Greenville was 2-for-2 on shots, and Clayton State had none. They're now tied at 12 shots apiece. Might be number 13 here for North Greenville, and That back line for Clayton State getting in the way. Siobhan Blake back in the game now for the Lakers as well, able to move it forward, trying to pick up Dwamina. North Greenville again has been able to hold Dwamina in check. He's the big guy for Clayton State. Two goals on the season for him as Kendrick called upon again. Makes the save in front of Connor Atkinson. Or no, that's Foster. That eight looks so much like a nine, or that nine looks so much like an eight.
And kind of lost throughout all this. You mentioned 12 shots apiece.
Cover for him.
So 24 total shots in the game, 20 of those coming in the first half.
Now whistle and a foul against Clayton State.
Now North Greenville going to get a free kick.
And it has been a frustrating game for the Lakers. That's their 11th foul. They've been called offside five times throughout the match.
And hate to harp on it, but also the red card has been pretty detrimental towards their attack.
No, mistakes have been on the menu for Clayton State. North Greenville, nine fouls and a yellow card. Here on the free kick, Roberson in, lines, runs over it, and he'll hand off the chip shot, looking for Green, and just missed him. And the referee says, back to Clayton State we go.
Call for a foul in the box, going to result in a goal kick. Just under 15 minutes to go. North Greenville still leading by three.
And North Greenville getting back into conference play. Two of their next three games are conference games against Barton. Well, the first one's against Barton and the other one against King. But all three, the next, all of those next three on the road. If you can count Bob Jones as being on the road, which I guess technically 20 minutes away is a road game.
The fans travel well to that game.
Yeah, I would say so, yeah. So if you're still looking to see a Crusaders play, not a far road trip at all to Bob Jones. Yeah, here comes Clayton State. They've got a man, that's Blake, the defender, up into the box. And the header saved by Gus Johnson. And cleared out. North Greenville looking for somebody to step up in place of the great defender in his time here, Lucas Gravely, and Gus Johnson trying to fill that role. But of course I'm not just saying that because he went to Pickens.
You're not proud of your alma mater or anything. Or people from your alma mater.
Well, just look at the I guess you would say the other football team here at North Greenville. Unfortunately, the start in Gulf South play held off due to Hurricane Florence, but you still got Matt Gravely out there breaking his brother Justin Gravely's record. As we have a, is that a bug?
Yeah.
A bug has entered the camera frame. So, yeah, you could say I am kind of proud there. Shout out to, is that Roger Cowell up there running the camera
yeah.
for us? Thanks, Rod.
Appreciate it.
Great basketball player for North Greenville and bug swatter. Time's starting to run out against Clayton State. Down three goals, 12 minutes to go. As we will have a substitution here. Casey Brady off for North Greenville.
James Segovia coming back on. For real this time.
For real? Yes.
So you can't tell an eight from a nine. I can't tell an eight from a zero. So.
Well, at least we haven't played Uno in a while.
Sevens and zeros?
Well, I guess let me rephrase that. I guess we haven't played it for 2.5 hours.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Whistle and a foul here against North Greenville in a spot you don't want one. Free kick for Clayton State coming up right on the edge of the box. And
North Greenville already scoring from this exact same position earlier in the match.
It's Casey Brady's free kick. That was the one that put him up 2-0. It was. So Clayton State might not be done yet. But they have got to score quick. Perunin to take the kick. Zach Baker still on the hunt for his hat trick, trying to get North Greenville their first hat trick in just under a year. Approaching that year anniversary on October the 11th. I guess you can call that an anniversary.
It's 1 year, so yeah.
So kick on the way, high and left, no good.
Same idea as before, but just a little too much.
North Greenville will breathe a sigh of relief. The three-goal lead stands. 10.5 minutes left in the match. This will be a statement win for this program against a team you've never beaten. Fifth meeting between these two schools all time. And against a stellar Peach Belt program that has struggled out of the gate this year, but they obviously have speed out there, so if Pete Peterson and Trent Orndorff and Avery Shepard can piece that all together, this could be a good good program down the stretch. Of course, you still got about a month and a half left in the season.
And North Greenville right here, if they can indeed hold this three-goal lead for another just under 10 minutes, moves to 3-1-1 on the season. And that's an incredible start for this program.
Shot into the box for Clayton State, rolling dangerously and stopped by Kendrick as Jack Stevens was trying to line it up. And for North Greenville, they've got a conference win over Erskine, the tie against Lees McRae. And you've got, of course, you've still got Mount Olive and Limestone. They're down the stretch. Those are two good powerhouses in this conference. Beaumont Abbey, another one. They'll probably be the top three as running North Greenville running free, and they've got another player down at midfield. It was Baker who took the tumble. He's helped back up.
Immediately looked in the way of the referee, wondering why there wasn't a whistle before. Just got body slammed back to the ground.
He did get one, so North Greenville here with a free kick right to Clayton State. Trying to wind the clock out. Domina down the middle. Over to Stevens. Cross into the box, headed up. Good stop there by Erkins. And North Greenville trying to get it cleared out. And so close there, but rebounded back to Stankovic, who fires the head save by Gus Johnson.
Just turned his back and hoped for the best.
Took that one in force.
That was a full power shot from about 4 feet off his back.
North Green was going to get it back, though. Clayton State losing it out of bounds. Going to check up on Conference Carolina's men's soccer here in a little bit with 7.5 minutes to go. Trying to see if we can get a scope of where this Crusader program is headed, and now another Crusader player down on the far side. And look, we're going to stop the clock and go take a look at this.
This is what you hate to see. Just not dirty play or anything, really, coming out of this. Just hard play and just player after player after player going down.
He's up and okay. Didn't have to send a trainer out there at least.
But Ben McKay going to come on in substitution.
And a high pass for Clayton State. Chipped back to Tarunin. Looking to fire. Does. And just misses wide left. Ooh, he had Kendrick leading and trying to aim for that left post.
Kendrick guessed left and he guessed wrong. Had to double back and go for the right. Luckily for him, just wide of the left post anyway.
So coming up on this free kick from Kendrick. North Greenville right now in the Conference Carolinas. The conference record 1-0-1. There's another foul. This one going to be against North Greenville. It's Clayton State with a player down. But North Greenville second in the conference behind Emmanuel, who is 2-3 overall, but those two conference wins, But they have those two wins coming in conference play, so 2-0 conference record. So that game, they're going to have to make that one up against Emmanuel. How about that deflection off the free kick? Limestone third at 1-0, tied for third with Southern Wesleyan at 1-0.
And as you said, North Greenville with a chance, two conference games on this three-game road trip. Chance to get a couple more Conference Carolinas wins.
They're going to have to play tough, no doubt there.
And they've shown they've had the ability. If they play to their fullest potential, they have every right and chance to beat any opponent.
Now we're starting to have a outbreak of whistles and fouls late in this half. And North Greenville has been the guilty party. Free kick here for Dean Foster. Eventually. Referee talking with a couple North Greenville defenders getting the wall formed up there. Foster doing that stutter step. And here we go. And it curls wide right again. He had Kendrick out of place. And did anybody touch that on the way? That will be a corner kick for Kendrick.
And, yes, they will whistle that Kendrick did get a touch. Short corner coming off for Clayton State. Mm-mm.
And the offside flag up. That is a half dozen offside calls against Clayton State. North Greenville coming in for the conference poll. Looks like our pick next to last. So something Coach Martin's telling that to his guys. Hey, we've got something to prove this season. Don't let these guys underestimate us.
Yeah, the record hasn't been there the last few years for North Greenville. Not having a lot of luck in the wins, loss, ties columns. But the talent has been there. When knocking on all cylinders, everything will work. And today is just an example of that.
Here's Foster trying to line up the shot, bouncing loose on the edge of the box. North Greenville not able to clear it. Foster back to Duamina. Duamina can't get it in as it will be fired out of bounds. Another corner kick here for Clayton State.
Fell off the ball and basically just tried to fire it from the ground, gets a deflection, and earns a corner.
Cross in, bounced up out of the box. North Greenville able to get it out. And now off to the races. Zach Baker running out of time to get his hat trick. Back to McKay. 3-on-2 here for a moment. Now two defenders step up, and it goes right to the keeper, Pustinen.
And ripped away the goal kick.
Houstonin fires up and gets it to midfield. And North Green will let that one get behind him. And Siobhan Blake almost had free reign there behind the defense. North Green will just look a little bit slack there, but able to recover. Greenville with a chance, though. Baker calling for it right side, going to Green down the middle and couldn't get a good strike to it as Pustinen on the save.
Green just a step too far, couldn't get his leg wound up and around. Made contact, but just not on goal.
Now Clayton State, everybody's getting behind the defense. Here's Dromina trying to line up left post. Kendrick will get out of spot. Somebody made a last stand save there on the line.
Referee calling fair play, no penalty.
Yeah, everybody plays on. So 1:40 left to go. North Greenville in the driver's seat. Next game for this men's team of North Greenville on the road at Barton before returning back to South Carolina against Bob Jones, also on the road. And coming up for us here on the North Greenville Sports Network, now part of the Conference Carolina's digital network, women's soccer tomorrow night against Emmanuel. Trying to make up that doubleheader series that was postponed due to Hurricane Florence coming into the area.
1 minute remaining.
Final minute here for the match. So we will have women's soccer for you here on the Conference Carolina's digital network tomorrow night at 7. And to check out more information about Crusader Athletics, don't forget you can go to nguathletics.com and to follow what we're doing here on the North Greenville Sports Network. That is our YouTube page, youtube.com/North Greenville Athletics. Just crossed over the 1,000 subscriber mark. So keep those milestones coming as Zach Baker fires the last heave, and that might be his last good crack at the hat trick, so it doesn't look like it will come tonight. Still a whale of an effort there for Zach Baker. 2 goals of the 5 on the board for North Greenville today. Foul and a whistle against Clayton State. North Greenville foul with 30 seconds left. So they'll take their time here lining up the free kick, let the clock wind down to about 15 seconds, and just try and play some keep away here from Clayton State. Over the far side is Matate. 10 seconds to go. No pressure from Clayton State. Nothing doing for North Greenville to push forward. They'll go back to Kendrick, and he'll walk it out. And North Greenville has earned their first victory in program history over Clayton State. So that overall record now improves to 4-1. And despite the Lakers outscoring North Greenville 23-3 coming in, North Greenville outscores them for the match 5-2. Your final score here from Pepsi Stadium, as North Greenville improves to 3-1-1. Clayton State falls to 1-4-1. And final stats coming up, as we'll take a look at those. Again, your final score 5-2. North Greenville wins over Clayton State as we head to Scranton, Pennsylvania for some Dunder Mifflin. The office will walk us out. The final numbers, 9 of 13 on shots on goal for North Greenville. Very good number. Coach Martin will be pleased with that. Clayton State, 8 of 17. Corner kicks, turned out Clayton State did win that category, 3-2. And Noah Kendrick, 6 saves. And Larry Frere and Kerry Pustinen tally up 4 saves, or 4 saves total. And so the final numbers there, that's a look at your final stats. And I don't know if we even do it anymore, but I'm going to bring it back, revive it, if you will. Player of the game, number 28, Zach Baker, 2 goals for him.
Absolutely great shots coming off him, 2 incredible goals, and ends up scoring 2 of the 5 for North Greenville to help put this one to bed. And just a great all-around effort, even before the red card showed to Frere. North Greenville pretty much was dominating on the attacking side. Maybe not possession, maybe not anything else, but defense to counterattack, very successful. 2 goals before the red card, 3 goals after. 1-1 for Clayton State.
Now, North Greenville never panicked in this game despite the speed from Clayton State. And you got to give credit to the Lakers. They ended up outshooting North Greenville 17-13, but it's not the most shots that count. However, it is the ones that get buried in the back of the net, obviously. So, North Greenville first win over Clayton State in program history. 3 wins now on the year for North Greenville, and they will put that record on the road for the next 3 games at Barton, at Bob Jones, and at... I already forgot the third one. It was a conference. King. It was at King. At Barton, at Bob Jones, and at King. So that will close us out. Here from Pepsi Stadium, first goals of the season scored today for Gareth Green for Metro Tarunen, and Ben McKay getting his first goal. of the season today as well. Hope to have you out here tomorrow night at Pepsi Stadium for North Greenville Emmanuel as we try to make that match up in women's soccer. And to follow more North Greenville athletics information, NGUathletics.com, the place to go. Also, YouTube.com/North Greenville Sports Network. Also, don't forget to follow along with the Conference Carolinas Digital Network. So for Alan Ellis, for myself, Gray Sullen, saying farewell here from Pepsi Stadium. See you tomorrow night, whether it be over across the way in the stands or on the interwebs here on the Conference Carolinas Digital Sports or Digital Network. 5-2, your final score. North Greenville wins over Clayton State. This has been a production of North Greenville Soccer here on the Conference Carolinas Digital Network.